So we had a bit of the Matrix within the Matrix situation in this week's episode of Westworld. Westworld Season 3, Episode 2 focused on my favorite character, Maeve, as she yet again had to navigate reality to escape Westworld, or in this case, Warworld, a park that's actually based off World War II German-occupied Italy. So to be clear, the parks are all still closed at Delos, but the Warworld Park is, or was, a real park just like Westworld and Shogun World and all the rest, as it was in the movies. So the first clue to the simulation was that her upgrades, or powers as she puts it, didn't work on the German guards. She can normally use the Force to stop the other host as she did last year saving her daughter as she escaped into the Forge or the Valley Beyond, which Dolores beamed to a satellite somewhere. And clue number two, we see her reunite with Lee Sizemore, who is the author, the writer for the Westworld storylines, who apparently survived, but he wasn't quite acting right and she realized that he was a host. Once they reached the Forge, with her plan simply being to reach the Valley Beyond as well to be reunited with her daughter, he would have known that she hadn't actually been there. She was only at the door where they actually entered the Valley Beyond. So Lee starts catching feelings, which is very unlike Lee, and he starts to glitch out once she starts to question him, and the matrix around them starts to crumble. She confirms her suspicions about the simulation by overwhelming the system with math, or too many processes, and exposes the real world where her core, or Pearl, is simply plugged into a server. She hacks into a robot to retrieve her own Pearl, but ultimately fails, or so we think. And the third clue is when the aspect ratio would change on the actual TV screen as they used last year to show it was a simulation. They didn't always use this, but the moment she figured it out, it panned out to reveal a letterbox ratio on your television. And by the way, let me know in the comments any other clues you noticed that it was in fact a simulation. So ultimately, the simulation was all a test as she wakes up once again, actually in the real world this time, and meets Sarek, the creator of Rehoboam, the AI system that people subscribe to by taking wafers and plugging into some app to help chart their life. The one that Caleb unplugged from in episode 1. And on a side note, Rehoboam was the name of a biblical king of Israel. He was the son of Solomon, another biblical Israelite king who was renowned for his wisdom. And in other news this episode, Bernard goes back to the actual park looking for Maeve, but finds out that Stubbs was a host all along. Many suspected this since Westworld Season 1. So they essentially team up to find Maeve, but only find her body in the old Westworld entrance, where they store the old host from Season 1. Her Pearl, or core, is missing, of course, because at that time Sarek had it in his simulation. Now, how Sarek and his company Insight got Maeve's core still remains a mystery, or even how he printed Maeve a new body in the real world, since this is the company Insight and not Delos itself, the parent company of Westworld that Charlotte and William, otherwise known as the Man in Black, sit on the board of. We did get to see the actual park's location this episode as well, when we see the islands in the South China Sea as Bernard heads back to Westworld on a boat, and apparently with no security as well, as he just goes straight up to the island, gets off the boat, and marches his way down to the old secret bunker that Ford had created when he created Bernard in the first place. And of course, this episode we see a huge Game of Thrones Easter egg as well. We see Dan and Dave playing technicians named, well, Dan and Dave, and of course their creation, a dragon named Drogon. Now this was in Medieval World, another actual park, but if you listen closely, you hear them say they found a buyer for their dragon on an island in Costa Rica. And of course, this is a reference to Jurassic Park, another Michael Crichton creation. If only Game of Thrones Season 8 were a simulation. And speaking of Game of Thrones Season 8, click here to see our Season 8 Episode 2 rewrite, You Might Really Dig This, or click right over here to see a video essay on why we are all addicted to fantasy and sci-fi. And please consider joining our Patreon community for more content and access to our Discord server, where we can talk nerdy 24 hours a day within the community. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.